our brand new monster validator that we're running live on mainnet on the Solana chain. I'm so excited about this thing. I just have to share all the technical details with you. And this thing is available to you for staking, right? So let's dive right into it. If we look at StakeWiz here you see our Xandeum validator with, you know, all the great stats that we're having and all the, you know, 100% uptime and, you know, no, and you know, the uptrend here and the Wiz score and all these type of things, right? And right now, since yesterday, it is running our brand new hardware, right? So it might be a little bit oversized right now, but you know, we can handle all these moments of heightened load in the Solana chain and still be active and, you know, produce blocks and everything when other validators can't, right? And here's the secret to success. If you host your validator on one of the recommended hosting companies, they give you the same hardware in the same data center as everyone else is running their validators. If you want to stand out, as we have been doing with our Xandeum validator for over a year now, and you know, our stake is growing and growing, and we're you know, approaching the 500,000 SOL mark, right? So 500,000 SOL at, like, you know, say a SOL price of $100, that's $50 million, right? And people are trusting their money, stake it with our validator. And by the way, staking on Solana doesn't mean you put your fund at risk, right? Your funds are safe in the Solana blockchain. All the staking is implemented in Solana, and we cannot access your fund, right? We are just working to give you that APY, right? That 8-point-something% return that you can get from staking. And that's all you can put at risk if you stake with us, right? It might be less than 8% if for some reason we don't perform anymore, right? But we have been performing all the time, and we pledge to perform. We have two redundant validator hardwares now in two different cities. The new monster validator is in North Las Vegas, Nevada, and the secondary is in Troy, Michigan, right? So even if something happens to any of these cities, we can switch and hot switch. It's a hot standby, so we can, you know, switch over in sub-seconds. So everything's redundant there. And the primary now is that monster that I'm going to tell you about. So you can stake your SOL to us anytime. Just go to Xandeum.com. That's our website here. And there's that button stake here. And there you can stake your SOL with us. It's super easy to do. And the new hardware that we have is Ansel hardware. So I'm not only the founder and CEO of Xandeum, but I still run my older company, Ansel. We have these Ansel appliances here. And here's that Ansel 2. And the one that we're running there is the Ansel 2 Plaid. So if you're interested in getting any of these pieces of hardware, you know, there's always that chat in the bottom right of the Ansel.com website. Here's how it's spelled, Ansel. And also, you can just email sales@ansel.com, and we quote you any piece of hardware that you need for your Solana validator or for anything else. So that said, now let's look into what we're having here. And so I'll actually jump right into the validator itself. Boom, here we are. So the name of that thing is called Vinca. So I name all my devices and all my servers, you know, by flowers, trees, cacti, anything that blooms, simply because my name is Bloom, right? And Vinca is a very nice flower, and it blooms. All right. So on Vinca here, let's do just a simple LSCPU. And that tells us what CPU we have in here. And what we see here is that we have, so let us scroll up here, right? Just to show you what kind of beast that is, right? Boom, boom, boom. Okay, so Control B, this one, and scroll up. So let's check it out here. We have two processors here, two AMD EPYC 9174F 16 core processors, right? So these have multi-threading. So basically they have 32 cores per processor, and we have two of those. So we have, as you see in the top here, we have 64 CPUs, right? And they have a base clock of 4.1 gigahertz, right? And they have all the latest instruction sets and so on and so forth. So why do we need fast CPUs and lots of cores on Solana? Well, we need the multiple cores to do the proof of history, right? Proof of history means the proof of history is being generated with one core, but it can be verified with multiple cores. So the faster we can verify and validate the proof of history and also do signature verification, the more performant the validator is. And this is the latest AMD EPYC. It's the fourth generation. It's brand new. It has that super high clock speed. We have 64 cores in that, and each one is 4.1 gigahertz. Usually the more cores you have, the slower the clock frequency, just for thermal reasons, right? So if the clock speed is high and the number of cores is high, then the whole thing gets very, very hot. This one is thermally super sound. And by the way, you can have it also if you want to order it from Ansel. We can even host it for you or find you a co-location space. Just email sales@ansel.com if interested. So this is a very, very hot machine. So now this new machine is also able to support DDR5 RAM. So all our RAM, all our memory is ECC. That's error correcting code. So just bit errors do happen at times. That's why sometimes you just have to reboot your PC or your phone or something like that, because just by coincidence, a bit flips in the memory, and then you just have to reboot it. That would be not good for a server, right? So that's why we're using ECC, error correcting code. They have like additional bits that can do kind of a checksum and auto-correct some of these errors, right? Or most of these errors that appear, right? So that's the reason these machines can run without rebooting for years and years and years, right? So we have that, and how much RAM do we have in here, right? So let's do a free dash H here. And we see we have 1 terabyte of RAM in here, right? Only 69 gigabytes are being used right now. 331 are free, and we have 201 shared and 600 used as a cache or buffer, right? So I'll dive into that, what that all means, because we are using some of these RAM disks, right? For example, the, so you see it here again, 1 terabyte of RAM and all these values that I just read for you. 1 terabyte of RAM, I mean, holy crap, right? So we can run a lot of RAM disk, right? So for the accounts, right, the Solana accounts, those are being read from and written to often, right? It's like it changes so much. So if you put that on an SSD, an NVMe SSD, it'll wear down the SSD real fast. And also, you need the highest speed possible for these accounts, because that's critical for the performance of the validator, right? So if we do a df-h here, df means disk-free, and the dash h means put it in a human-readable format, then we see that, what do we have here? We have the accounts here on what's called a tempfs, and tempfs just means it's a RAM disk, right? So it's kept in RAM. We have it 300 gigs, 200 are used, right? So the validator is running right now. It's using 200 gigs for the Solana accounts, right? And they are all kept in memory. We don't even need a disk for that. And then we have four NVMEs here, right? So the NVMe 0, that's our root file system. That's where the operating system resides. And we're also putting the logs on there, right? And there's a few things that are being written to often, but read only rarely, right? So that includes the logs, right? The logs are mostly being written to, and only sometimes we read them. Then there's also the ledger. It's mostly being written to, right? And then there's the snapshots and the incremental snapshots. So if we can have all these on different NVMe drives, and we have, you know, data center quality NVMe drives in there, it's the Samsung Pros, right? So those are the fastest and highest endurance NVMe drives that you can get on the market. They are almost as fast as RAM, right? And we have four of those. And on the root file system, NVMe 0, we have the operating system, and we also have our logs there, right? And then we have the ledger, the snapshots, and the incremental snapshots all on their own NVMe drives, which is absolutely crazy, because that way we can optimize performance, right? Because it's all being written to, and if we do that to different drives, then the performance is being optimized, because we don't have that bottleneck with just one channel that writes to one NVMe drive. It can do everything in parallel, right? And I find that so exciting, man. And if you find that too exciting and you need to calm down, well, maybe you'll just take a look at my fireplace that I have here right in my little studio. So I love my studio, and it has its own fireplace. I love it. So, that's the inside view into that validator. It has a 25 gigabits per second network adapter. It's connected to a very fast connection in that North Las Vegas data center, and it can boost speeds up to 25 gigabits, which is sometimes needed. Most of the time, a Solana validator just needs 300 megabits, 350 megabits, but in times of congestion, in times when it needs to catch up with the blockchain or things like that, there can be bursts, right? Or in times of high load and stuff like that. So we can burst up to 25 gigabits, which is awesome, right? It's one step above the 10 gigabit technology that used to be state of the art, right? And so we're prepared for the future, right? And it shows in the performance of our validator that's being monitored by many independent websites. So what we have here, for example, is the independent website named StakeWiz. It's not here. It's here. So and we've been consistently among the top 10. We've been the number one for a long, long time. But now we've gained more stake, so more people are trusting us. And that, you know, costs us a few points in StakeWiz's point system. So it's tough for us to be number one at like 470,000 SOL in stake here. But nevertheless, sometimes we're even number one. But most of the time, we're among the top 10 here, right? Which is awesome. And we've done that consistently for a long, long, long time. So, yeah, and you know, you can stake your Sol to us through that website. And I hope you like this little video. Please give me that thumbs up button. Destroy the like button. I would really, really appreciate it. And leave me some comments here about your experience with Solana staking. What do you think about our latest hardware? Fully redundant. We still have the other validator in the Michigan data center. So that we have all the redundancy. And yeah, this is, you know, it's just a fantastic machine. I'm so happy we have that. And we're prepped for the future and for all kind of weird events that might happen on the Solana chain to give you the highest returns and the highest security that we can still, you know, work for you and get these 8-point-something% APY even in you know, adverse conditions that the Solana chain might get into. So yeah, I hope you enjoyed this little video. Thanks so much for watching, guys. Catch you next time, and peace.